Hi there, everybody. Welcome to Intermediate Keyboard Class. This is a song that I've been working on for a little bit of time right now, and I am struggling with some of the middle sections. It's called The Letter in there, and it's got a lot of 16th note passages that really force me, even as a professional pianist and musician, to sit down and drill and work hard and make sure that I'm doing correctly. So I'm going to record this video a little bit later on and post to this page, but I wanted to give you, our intermediate keyboard students, just kind of a early preview into what that sounds like. This composer is great, so I wanted you to hear that. Well, welcome to Intermediate Keyboard Class today. And today we're going to do a couple things to help you take those next steps to be an incredible pianist, okay? First things first, remember, anytime that we do keyboard, you want to have it out, make sure it's plugged in or that you've got batteries, make sure that you're doing that right now, even as I'm talking to you. You want to have everything ready. You're not going to need your book today, either your red book or your blue book, depending on which one that you're in. I'm going to be going off of something a little bit different that I want to teach you, kind of a really fun at-home lesson in chords. The Facebook page that you're probably on right now, or if you're watching this a little bit later, we'll have this file linked to it. But the Facebook page has this document uploaded right now. And so you're able to either download that or print that off. You don't have to have it right now if you're too busy to get to your printer, but you're gonna wanna use this and start practicing, because everything that we do today is gonna really be geared off of this one page, all right? First things first, let's make sure keyboard's ready, everything's set up, and then if you've never done one of these keyboard sessions before, one of these virtual things, don't worry about it. You play along as much as you can. You do your very best and everything. And then if you have any questions, we're here for you. Email us afterwards. Mr. Weir, I didn't know what you were talking about when you did this part on there. Or Mr. Weir, I watched the video again and around the 8-minute mark, you were talking about something and I didn't know what you were talking about. I'm happy to email back and respond and to help. We want you to be awesome. Okay, so hang in there, do your best. And then if you need to watch this video again and pick up some of the things that you might have missed, you can certainly do that too, okay? First things first, let's come over to the piano. My videographer's getting in close here. Notice, first of all, my piano's broken. I am very embarrassed about this and saddened. This note right here, my E, has been broken. It stays down most of the time. And so I'll be playing a song and then suddenly that key won't be working. So what I'm gonna do for the purpose of today is I'm gonna move up an octave But I want to hear my regular sounds right here in the middle of my piano. So I'm going to hit the transpose button up here, and I'm going to take it down 12 whole steps. You can see that it says transpose 12 steps. And so now my notes up here sound like they're in the middle of the keyboard. So as you play today, what you're going to find is you'll hear the normal sound that I want you to hear based on the middle of your piano, but I'm playing an octave higher, and it's hard to get during this quarantine part to get a professional to come out and take a look at it, okay? First things first, let's take a look at our chords. We don't have a lot of these in our group piano class books. We start seeing them more in the blue book. But a chord is three notes that you do all at the same time. This is a C chord. Take a look at it. I'm playing a chord or a triad. It's three notes that together sound really nice together, and that you as a keyboard student or as a pianist really need to make sure that you know. Now, I'm also a band director, so I do a lot of trumpet playing, brass, woodwind, and my wife is a professional flautist. She can play the most beautiful, amazing, fast parts, but most of those instruments can only play one note at a time. So here's a flute doing a great job, and maybe they can play it super fast, but they can't do this. Two notes or three notes at the same time. That's something special that we as pianists have, because we have multiple notes that we can play together. So first thing I want you to do is I want you to find your C. All right, if you're not used to finding C, you've got your set of two black keys and the C is right next to it. I usually teach my beginners Oreo cookies. Here's your black cookie, white cream and black cookie. Oreo cookies are delicious. You wipe the cream, there's your D, and C is right next to it. So C, D, E, F, G. These are most of the notes that we're gonna be using today. C, D, E, F, G. And for the purpose of this chord, we're gonna play a note, skip a note. Play a note, skip a note, play a note. There's your C chord right there. Now, the neat thing about your chords, one of the things that you might have done with keyboard in the past is when you first opened up your keys and you saw that they were black and white keys, you saw that there were patterns all over the keyboard. So two black keys, two black keys, two black keys. And your teacher might have even had a race for you to get acclimated. All right, now it's time for three black keys. Showing you that all over the piano, we still have those same patterns. Well, same thing with our chords. We have our C, and we have a C up here, and a C up here. This is actually a C on my keyboard. All C's on there. So when we learn this chord, I'm gonna be able to play it here in the middle of the piano, but I can also play it up here if I need a song that maybe has birds, or a song that sounds really sweet. I can play it down here. If I need a song with some oomph down there at the very bottom. So it's important for us to know this, all right? For now, let's do this. That's C. I want you to put your middle finger, your third finger on that C. Find it right on your keyboard, two black keys, and your third finger on that C. And then your pinky, we're gonna put on the E. So you should have C and E right now, right hand only, third finger, fifth finger, C and E. Now, I talked about the G being played. We're gonna bring that G down here and play it with the thumb. So this is the chord you should be playing right now. It's a C chord with the thumb on the bottom with a G down there. So find that closely. Middle finger on the C, and then the E, fifth finger, and then first finger a G. If you've never played chords like this before, it might feel weird to your hand. Maybe you're used to one finger at a time. It's important then to play it several times. This is teaching the hand how to get three fingers to play at the same time. Do it several times with me. One, two, ready, begin. Chord, chord, nice and easy. Very good. I hope very good. I can't hear you from here, but I bet you're doing good. Very good, very good. Okay, so that's the first one that we want to do. Our left hand is going to do this. We're going to put our left hand first finger on a C. All right, so you've got your two black keys right here, and then Oreo cookies are D, that's a D. Here's your C. All right, so first finger left hand on a C. The whole time today, we're basically gonna play this. C with the first finger, F with the fifth finger. C and F. I had one teacher tell me that the F is the front door to this big house right here, the three black keys. You got the F right here next to the three black keys and the C. C and the F, okay? When I'm playing this chord up here with my right hand, C, E, G, which note do you think plays in the left hand? The C with the C chord or the F with the C chord? I hope you said C. Both will work, but for now, we're gonna play that C and that chord together. And so this is what you should sound like right now. Yes. Give it a try a couple times. If you're making a mistake with one hand, maybe your left hand is too much to add right now, then for now, just play the right hand. That's okay for you to do one hand at a time. All right, I wouldn't just play the left hand by itself. Yay, I got it. You know, I know you can do that. But this G, C, E, we want that several times so that our hand gets used to playing it, so that we can even carry on a conversation and still play the song and not even worry about it, okay? That'll help you be awesome. So here we go. We've got that right there. Now, when I go to the F in my left hand, I'm gonna play the same chord up here, but I'm gonna move my thumb to an A. I'm just gonna go one note up. So I was playing here. There it is. C chord, and then F chord. You see it? C chord, and then I move this thumb up to the A, and my pinky comes down to the F. Try it with me. Ready? One, two, three, C chord. C chord, two, three, four. Now I'm moving pinky to the F, and I'm moving my thumb to the A. One, two, three, four. C chord, two, three, four. F chord. That's the idea. One more time. C chord. Go. Very good. Very good. Now back up for a moment, camera guy. All right. The other element to this that we haven't quite talked about yet is what I'm doing down here on the floor with these pedals. Okay. Usually most keyboards or most pianos have these three pedals on here. If you're playing on a regular keyboard that you usually walk into school, you probably don't have those on there. But if you're sitting at home and you're looking at a keyboard, let me just tell you about these three pedals real quick, because most people have no idea what they do, okay? And even this piano, even this keyboard will be set up to do something totally different, all right? First things first, the one on the very right, this one right here, is called our sustain pedal, which is really, really cool. So watch, if I'm not pressing something down and I press my chord, the sound dies, it's gone. If I instead, I press this sustain pedal and press it, I can move my hands to other parts and get ready for a new section, and the keys are still playing. Now, it's technically dying. The sound's going away, but it's at least holds it up for a while. So I can... I'm just showing you that I can move my hands out of the way while keeping that sustained... important pedal that we have on there, okay? The left pedal usually does the same thing, where I can lock in something sustained like this, and then everything else can still sound nice and short on there if I need it. And then most middle pedals, I usually call them an apartment pedal. If you're playing on a little spinet piano, that's a small one, but a real piano, not an acoustic, not a digital one like this, what it'll do is it'll actually take a piece of felt and it'll lay it in between the hammer and the string on there. So suddenly it's very, very quiet and you can practice and almost nobody will hear you. It's really, really cool on there. For my purposes today, we're gonna be using this right pedal if you're looking at one. If you don't have one, don't worry about it. You just keep doing your best. And so this exercise sounds really smooth with the pedal on there. If you don't have the pedal, yours probably sounds like this. And you can hear that that sounds a little bit different, but it's still okay. It's good for you to learn this, all right? Last chord that we're going to learn right now before we put it together for a song is this one. Come close again, camera guy. We start with this one, and go ahead and do this with your fingers. Middle finger on C, third finger, E, G. There's your C chord that we're playing today. Left hand went on a C down here. Whenever we changed to an F down here, the thumb came up to an A. You can hear it. And that's technically called an F major 7 chord. It's an F chord, F down in here in the bass. And it has a 7th note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sounds really, really pretty. The other one we're going to do today is an F6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which is really pretty. Here's the one with the 7th. So instead of an E, I'm playing a D. My left hand stays down here on an F the whole time. I can play this many times as I want. And you can see that up here, the A stays the same, the C stays the same, but it's just this E that moves down to a D. Give it a try a couple times. Sixth. One more time. 7th chord, then the 6th. Very good. Up until now, all we've done is you and I have looked at the keys together. I want you to take a look at the page. Take a look on here. Zoom in, camera guy. The camera guy's my son today, so he's doing awesome. All right, right here we have chord progression. This is exactly what I played right now, and this is what you would see in your music. In the right hand, you see we have that E, C that you put your middle finger or third finger on, and then we have a G way down here. It's kind of hard to see that G. It's not hard for the video to see. It's tricky because there's so many ledger lines. You can see that I play 4 of them, and then this bottom one moves from a space up to the line, and that E moves down to a C, and then a repeat sign throws me right back to the beginning. Left hand with it, and the F. This time I'm not going to take the repeat sign. F major 7, F6, and then the C chord ends it. This is a really pretty song that you could use as a keyboard player for almost anything. This is Easter week. You could use it almost as a hymn. A month from now, Mother's Day is coming up. You could write a song. You know, I have not prepared this at all. I'm just thinking off the top of my head and saying, Mom, I love you. Thank you, Mom. You're so awesome. Thank you, Mom. And you could play her a song and sing it with your words. On there. You feed us well, and you take care of the dog and the house. You know, I don't know what your mom does, but you could easily use this as a song in the future for almost any purpose, which is great. One other thing I want to show you on here, take a look. It says playing with chord symbols. So again, everything you've done in the Red Book has been, let's see what the notes say. If you're looking at a blue book, your music is already on the staff and you see what you're supposed to be playing there. On this right here, this is usually how these songs are written. They're playing with chord symbols. And this is all you would see. They wouldn't write any of these notes right there. They would just say these up here. So I know when I see this C, my hand's going to do the same thing. Good. Camera guy, if you'll get hand and music. Let's see if we can get that, okay? So I see C. C chord, and then these slashes mean I'm playing for 4 beats. Then here's that F major 7. It doesn't tell me to do an F6, so I'm not switching to that D. Here's the F major 7. Now here's the C chord, then F major 7 again. Now this one we haven't learned. It says A minor. I'm gonna keep my right hand the same and just play an A in my left hand. And look here, we're back to F major 7. And then this one's an F6, but it says minor, so I'm going to do something different to it. Not a single note is written right here, just these chord symbols. And what that allows you and I to do is play really nice music and to make up our own things and for it to sound really impressive without the worry of, wait, what's that note on the staff?
Wait, is that a D or a C? Wait, so as you learn these chords, it's going to really open up the opportunity for you to be a better player and to play a lot more types of things. Let me play a little more. I'm playing this C again. This time, instead of me playing them as a straight block chord, I'm going to do an open chord. So I'm still playing all three of those notes, but in a different way. Now the F. Back to C. And F major. Okay? Earlier we talked about how they're the same all over the piano. This time I'm going to play the same thing, but now I'm going to explore maybe higher sounds and lower sounds. Here we go. C chord. Minor, F major 7, F the minor 6, and the C. Again, this is the type of thing that we're not trying to do this for personal glory in terms of, hey, everybody, listen to me, I'm a really good piano player. That's not the goal of why we learn music, but this is the type of thing that make people say, wow, listen to that really beautiful, talented playing. And all it is just a couple of chords. Okay, it makes it very, very easy. So, quickly, assignment. First things first, print out this page and use it as part of your assignment. You want to be able to learn and see those. And again, if you need help from me or from your other piano teacher, we're happy to email. You know, oh, I can't ever get that F major 7. How do I do that again? What finger should I use? At the beginning, I'm happy to help with those things. The other assignment, though, is this one right at the bottom. Come on, zoom in, camera guy. Notice what this says, chord inversions. All right, super easy left hand, C, C, just some whole notes. But in the right hand, we have our regular C chord. These are actually all C chords right here. They're just inverted or flipped, okay? Take a look at my hand again. At the very beginning, we said a C chord is C, E, and G, right? Remember? And then we took this G off the top and put it on the bottom. You remember that? Okay, so let's put the G back on top. 1, 3, 5. That's a regular C chord right there. When I invert it, it means taking a note off and putting it somewhere else. So if I take the C off and instead put it at the top, that's a C chord in first inversion. If I take the E off now and I put it at the top, that's a C chord still in second inversion. And then when I take this G off and put it at the top, I'm back to my regular C chord right there. And that's what's written out here. Your assignment is to practice these chords. Nice and easy. I have them written as half notes, so take your time. Half note, and then move that C up, okay? Still the E and the G, now there's the C. Got it, now take the E off. Got it? Now take the G off. C chord, right there. You want to be very comfortable with this right here. You're probably not doing it this fast, that's okay, but you want to get it to the point where it's not, the goal isn't that you have to be fast or tense. Relax. Without the pedal, yours probably sounds like that. That's okay. We can even come backwards. And all I'm doing is I'm reading the chords backwards, just like that. This is your big assignment on here. So again, remember, all you can do is your best. So if you feel like one of those chords was a problem, that's okay. You haven't failed in any way. It's just new information. My daughter started the flute just a couple of weeks ago. And one of the things that I wrote on her first page was that a wrong note or playing it wrong the first time happens all the time. It does. It's you're going to make some mistakes, and it's not going to be perfect every single time, and that's okay. What that is an opportunity for you to see yourself get better. So if you're playing that chord, oh dang, something's wrong here. I'm not quite doing it right. Then when it does come out right, that means you got better at it. on there. Okay, so you keep working at it. You keep doing your best. And again, if you have any questions, I'm happy to help. Just send me an email or a voicemail or a text or a little video of you playing, and I'll be happy to show you exactly where we can fix
things. And again, okay? Best luck. You work hard. Let us know if you have any questions. I've got my little playing buddy right here. Play for somebody. Music was meant to be shared, so you share it. Have a great day.